I'm back for the finals. I'm on the draw with a pretty reasonable hand, and my opponent is multi six. But seems to happily keep six cards. Like that I have all my colors. I like that Scout the Borders can make any delve cards that I draw really good. I like that I can find some creatures. All right, black-white warriors. Flooding out a little bit here. Could definitely use a treasure cruise or something like that after you scout the borders. Probably want to get this into play. Next turn, I can scout the borders and hope to hit Hooting Mandrills. Sidisu would be great. Rakshasa Vizier would be great. Sultai Soothsayer. Just gonna hold back my morph, I think. My opponent would definitely block if I attacked. Ooh, I do get the Hooting Mandrills. Perfect. What do I want to keep here? The Bonkin. I have to delve. Sorry, I have to delve everything. I was thinking about for the purposes of Cranial Archive if I wanted to keep any of those cards in my graveyard. Not a big deal either way, though. What? Still attacking? Mean, I'm gonna block. I think he's. There's not even anything that he could have, right? Feel like he's just trying to trigger Raid. I mean, you could have Dragon Scale Boon, Awaken the Bear, but those are just trades. I have no problem with that at all. Oh, he probably has the what's it called? The Horde Mate that returns a two drop to your from your graveyard to play. But I feel like this is just a bluff attack and or trying to trigger Raid. All right, so it's a 2-for-1 trade, which I'm perfectly fine with, especially after my opponent has mulliganed. One card left in hand only. So I'll scout the borders. Well, maybe I should just throttle that guy before it gets too big. Yeah, I guess that makes sense to do. No, it doesn't. What am I talking about? Why would I throttle that? Well, I mill my treasure cruise, which I don't like, but the Sultai Soothsayer is pretty much exactly what I was hoping to hit. Now, I'll Soothsayer into like Bitter Revelation, even Cranial Archive, I wouldn't hate. Yeah, in re after thinking about it a little more, throttling that creature would be a terrible play because I just want to save the throttle for something that's going to kill me and disown Ancestor. It's like he'd have to outlast four or five times and then attack me four or five times before it really would be a threat at all. I have so many ways to block ground creatures. Want Sidisi, although I'm getting like kind of in danger of decking myself. Let me think if I actually want Sidisi. I think I actually just want Sultai Flayer because I have 13 cards in my library, and if I play Sidisi and mill my Cranial Archive, then it's like I can never attack with Sidisi. It's kind of pointless. So let me get in for 2 damage here. Play some more big ground creatures. And just settle in for a long game. Wait to draw Bitter Revelation or Cranial Archive. Once they get big enough to attack, I can just set adrift the Disowned Ancestor. Or I can double block, throttle, something like that. I'm not too worried about them. At this point, the game's gone long enough. I have enough mana that I can actually carefully use Set Adrift to manage the cards that I'm going to shuffle back in with my Cranial Archive. Ooh, that might be a creature that's worth throttling eventually. Back of the flare. When I first started playing this format, I set the goal for myself that I was going to deal more damage with Archer's Parapet than any other player alive. Not sure, I haven't seen the leaderboard lately, but I think I'm doing pretty well. So it looks just like a pretty clean cut board stall at this point. I would like to wait until I draw Bitter Revelation to use Cranial Archive. Like, let's say I draw Bitter Revelation, I cast it, I delve away the lands in my graveyard, and then I play the Cranial Archive. Seems good. And then I use the Cranial Archive, I mean. I think it's time to throttle the Bondkin. In case I draw a card that I need to cast, I don't want to get caught with my pants down. Like if I cast a card and then he draws a removal spell, makes a big attack, and I can't throttle, could be ugly. Maybe I should have set Adrift the untapped one and gotten in some more damage there. No, probably not. Probably just correct to wait around at this point. There we go. That's good. Now, I think I'm going to delve away my 2 forests and my 2 scout the borders. And I think I want to leave the rest of the cards there. And this is perfect because it leaves me with enough mana to use the parapet and unmorph the monastery flock. Probably not worth it to attack. He could have Abzan Guide or any number of things. Sure, that's fine. It's not time to use the archive yet. I still want to draw the bitter revelation first. It is Abzan guide, okay. Turn this up. Wait one more turn? Yeah, I guess I can wait one more turn. I could be the one in time trouble this round. It goes to three games. But I'm pretty confident I'm gonna win this game. At a certain point, he can definitely attack with this seven power disowned ancestor. Man. Well, I feel like I'm committed to drawing my Bitter Revelation at this point. Only three cards left. Make sure I haven't exiled it. I have not. I have 14 lands in play, 3 exiled, so that means one of the cards in my graveyard is a land, in my library is a land, one's a Bitter Revelation, and what's the last one? Already used Murderous Cut. Not sure what it is. Maybe we'll find out. Heir of the Wilds. Not bad. Trades with one of these giant outlast creatures. The amount of outlasting in this game is really something. Okay, now I can crack this. Choose myself, of course. I should have cast it before the Hooting Mandrills, but no harm done. Think I want my Murderous Cut and my Set Adrift. Sidisi just decks me too quickly. think that my opponent has made a mistake by not attacking with Abzan Guide sooner. So I want a murderous cut, the Abzan Guide. I can't really cast Treasure Cruise in this game. And I could set adrift this. Yeah, that seems good. Come in with these guys. Literally has a 10 power disowned ancestor. I'm not sure if I've ever seen that before in my life. Alright. Well, it took me long enough, but I do win. I do win this game. I think I'm going to cut Death Frenzy. Seems like a slow matchup again. Bring in Dutiful Return, Rakshasa's Secret. Seems good. I could bring in Kintree Warden just to defend against the giant ground creatures. Probably not necessary though. Yeah, just -2. Plus Dutiful Return and Rakshasa's Secret. Same sideboarding as last round.